Good morning. Hello. Come in. My name is Dr. Andrew Michaels, and I'm here to help you. Please, sit down. Okay, let's get you situated. I want you right, if you don't mind, move right about here. That's right. That's good. And your name is? Okay, very good. Yes, you're here for a third eye alignment, is that correct? Okay. No. It's nothing to be ashamed of. I have to get a third eye alignment to pass my my certifications to qualify to just to help you, just to sit in the same room with you. So it's biannual. Any problems with your heart? Blood pressure? Any illnesses that I should know about? Very good. Well, we'll get started right away here. Okay. So let me feel. I can see. Yes. Feels like there's a little bit of a protuberance right here. Has it been bothering you for a while now? Oh, I bet. Don't worry. Let me see here. What we want to do is make you feel as comfortable as possible. It's very important that your comfort is observed as much as your care. It improves your chances of rehabilitation dramatically. It really does. If you don't mind, I'm going to take a quick look. Take a quick peek here. Now, don't worry. No harm will come to you, okay? Yes. It's right there. Yes. The reason I observed with my bare finger is we must have a skin-to-skin contact. Now that we do, I just want to check something real quick. Just hold on. Breathe in. Breathe out. Yes. Once more. Breathe in. Breathe out. Yes. Your heart rate is very calm. But there is a misstep in your beat. Your soul's out of alignment. You're definitely in need of a third eye alignment. Now, there's nothing to be afraid of. This is quite harmless. I've done it many times, and nobody's ever come out with any ill effects. First thing I need to do is put on my observation hood. And what this does is it aligns my third eye with yours. hold still. That's it. Hold still. I'm going to have to ask you to come in just a little bit closer. Don't worry. No harm will come to you. Oh, there we go. Now, this might look a little draconian, using a measuring stick, but we'll see how many. It's not that far off. You know, I think we can do it with a non-invasive procedure. Now, this looks a little ugly, but just hold still just for a second. Yeah. Let me check that. Yeah, we're definitely going to have to drive it a little bit back and forth. Ready? Up here closer. Easier to. Well, see, I use the measuring stick because what happens is I can get close, you know. I can get close, and then I can. I can do the alignment with the equipment better. Once I get it close, so hold still. Just a couple taps right here on this side. There. One more. I'm going to use a sharp end. It's not sharp, but it's a little more pointed. Won't hurt. See? Hold still. I might be making it worse. I think we have to go the other way. Hold still. It's not working. Hold on. One more. I was afraid of this. I'm making it worse. Let me do an octoscope alignment. Just try to hold still and remain calm. Okay, hold still. My third eye. Aligning with yours. Hold still. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. I can see the alignment issues now. If you can sustain that position, decrease the power of the probe slightly. Let me concentrate. I have to close my eyes. My third eye aligned with yours. Oh, yes. That's definitely the issue. This is troubling. I'm going to need you to try to remain as calm as possible. You are in a spiritual flux. Hold still. I'm just going to cut back that little bit of hair that's in the way. It's okay. Everybody's entitled to be in a spiritual flux once in a while. And I know it's frightening. It is. But you're letting the stresses and the problems of the world Just gotta move your bangs back. It's okay. You're in good hands. I just want to... make sure your hair doesn't get in the way for the next part of this procedure. Just move a few of those hairs out of the way. Just moving those little hairs gingerly out of the way. There we go. One little hair at a time. And we'll just brush you off a little bit with some talc. And some talc spray. There, just a little bit. A little bit of talc. And that helps cool the skin. Let me rub that in. And I'll massage the scalp a little bit. Alright. And massaging the scalp helps loosen the muscles and the tension in the skin. Mm-hmm. You definitely need this third eye alignment. You know, I've seen much worse cases. Yours is not that bad, but it's typical of this modern life that we live. There's so much divisiveness, so much anger, pardon me, so much anger and so much frustration. The divisiveness of our society has to stop. Mm-hmm. Well, it doesn't really matter what side you're on. If you're being divisive, it's bad, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That's right. So how could it be good and you're still divisive? You have to let these things go. There you go. All right. Good. 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 I'm going to just get that little bit of a scalp massage. Feels so good. Doesn't it? And rub the back of your head. Just the back. Down the scalp. And the sides of your neck. Rubbing the sides of your neck. And then your shoulders. Rubbing deeply into your muscles of your shoulders. There you go. Push your shoulders in. There you go. Mm-hmm. Now I'm going to push on your heart. Pushing on your heart now. Pushing on your forehead. Pushing on your top of your head. Pushing. 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 Pushing on the sides of your cheeks. Pushing on the sides of your neck. Feeling your heartbeat and your arteries on either side of your neck. And then pushing down on your shoulders. Now pushing on the sides of your shoulders. In your back, one hand to your front, on your heart, pushing on your heart, pushing, pushing on your heart, pushing, holding your heart. I'm holding your heart between my hands. Now both my hands, gently. Second. still. Okay. Lining up with your temple. Very close. Hold on, I have to write something down. Like a prescription, so we can fix it next time. Oh, that's very close. All right, now once more over here. Once more. And once more. And once more. And once more. Now this is going to be a little strange. Probably not used to this, but we're going to hit up into your forehead. Pushing the third eye alignment back into a more comfortable position for your cranium. Okay? Let me just check real quick. Oh, yes. Let me check with my machine. Let me get in close. Series. Everything is accepting the treatment much better now. Let me massage your forehead and your scalp one more time. There we go. Gotta keep that alignment sharp. Okay. Now, once more, this way. Once more. Too many there. No. That was very close. Just a little bit of talc. Just a little bit of talc. Keeping the skin soft. Pliable. Very pliable. Okay. Let's check the third eye alignment now. This does a much better job than me eyeballing it. Okay. This is what we call an observer test. To see if it rings true every time I sweep. Oh, and it does. It rings true every time. Let me get in close. Okay. Still. Oh, yes. Perfect. 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 I think we have a successful procedure. I do. I love giving third eye alignments. Now what I'm going to do is put some creamy cleanser on that area. We use a palette knife. There we go. just smooth it out a little bit. Very good. Now we're going to just do a heart alignment for you. Ready? Your heart is in very good shape. Hold still. Just want to listen. Steady. Breathe in normal. Oh, yes. Breathe in normal. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. It's not every day I get to hear a heart that strong. You have a courageous and strong heart. You do. And courage, my friend, courage will sustain a broken body. When your spirit and your mind and your heart, your soul, are in proper alignment, your courage, your strength, your determination will carry you through many, many bleak and hard times. It will. It most certainly will, my friend. And I am so glad I was able to do this procedure for you today. Oh, don't worry about the red marks on my head. It's fine. One time, I had a little piece of lint on my head during a procedure. And the patient was afraid to tell me. And I didn't notice it. Oh my God. And it just sat there the whole time. It was so embarrassing. And, you know, I have to laugh. You have to laugh sometimes. You really do. You've got to laugh at life's silly little things. And laughter is a good medicine. Yes, it is. Just let me check something real quick. Okay. Eyes look wonderful. And your third eye looks amazing. I am so proud of you today. You did such a good job. You really did. Your third eye is perfectly in alignment. It is. Aren't you happy? I know I am. I'm very happy. For you. Yes. Just for you. And a lot of times I do these things just for you. That's what a good doctor does. He does nice things for his patients. You give of yourself. And you make the world a little better place. Inch by inch, it's a cinch. Yard by yard, things get hard. So try to remember that. Just write a few notes down. And stay focused on bringing joy into the world. And not sadness. This is like a card for your future visits. We can basically draw in the eye and the third eye alignment and how many strokes I had to put on it to get it right. Feel better? That's nice. We're just going to do a real quick pressure test on the third eye area. Do you feel that? Do you feel that? Do you feel that? Do you feel that? Okay, what I want you to do now is I want you to take this small prescription card out to my, yes, the front desk, and they will put it with your file. We like to keep that out there on file in case I'm not here to help you. All right? And I will see to it that your permanent file also has a copy of the same information added to it. Because we don't want you to go through this where it's such a long and arduous alignment. Yes. Oh, no. You should be good for at least a year or two. Well, I go more often because I'm a professional and I use my third eye quite often. But I think being a layman, as you are, I think you'll be all right for a couple years. Just treat it like you're... eye exam. You go every couple years or every 3 years to get your eyes examined. It should be adequate. All right. Well, thank you. Thank you for being here today. You know, I don't think I stop in my day enough and say thank you to good people like you. The comments and the feedback I get from all of you is so wonderful. It really feels good. And it helps me stay determined to be the best professional I can be for you. Well, let me take off these dirty examination gloves. Dry my hands off. And then, I will gladly shake your hand. I'm proud to know you. I am. I'm proud to know you. And I'm proud that you brought me in to be part of your life. And I can't thank you enough for sharing your life with me. You're a genuinely good person. People are like that, you know. People are good people. They really are. If you spend all your time looking for evil, you'll find it. But if you spend all your time looking for good, you'll find that in abundance. So make the choice. Be the best person you can be. And make me proud. Most of all, make yourself proud. You're a great person, and you deserve the best. Until I see you again, please have a most blessed day. Okay?